Boris Johnson is facing the wrath of Tory backbenchers after his latest intervention on Brexit threatened to throw the government into fresh chaos. MPs openly told the Foreign Secretary to grow up or go after he drew a series of red lines for negotiations with the EU. Mr. Johnson has been criticized for maneuvering to take over from Theresa May in the wake of her disastrous election, which saw the Tories stripped of their overall majority. In an interview on the eve of the party's conference in Manchester this week, Mr. Johnson reopened cabinet splits by warning he is not prepared to stay shackled to the EU for a second longer once a mooted two-year transition ends in March 2021. The Brexiteer also complained of a lack of optimism about cutting ties with the EU, saying the Westminster bubble was out of touch. Damaging claims in the Sunday Times also make clear the depth of Mr. Johnson's disdain for the Prime Minister. He is said to have mocked Mrs. May as a slave to her powerful ex-aides Nick Timothy and Fiona Hill. That's modern slavery right there, he reportedly told a colleague, in a wounding reference to Mrs. May's high-profile campaign to eliminate modern-day slavery. A new documentary, Boris Johnson, Blonde Ambition, by Channel 4 News political editor Gary Gibbon and set to be broadcast tonight, reports that the Foreign Secretary privately believes that Mrs. May will not remain as PM for long. He thinks she's got a year at most, said a friend. Mr. Johnson is said to realize he has just one more go at the top job as the Tory rank and file are already turning to a new generation of MPs to provide the next leader. They think the whole cabinet is tainted by the election, one Tory MP has said. There are also reports that Mrs. May had first tried to manage Mr. Johnson by issuing a Thatcher-style slapdown, but that later number 10 resorted to an ego-stroking strategy to make him look like he was part of the trusted inner circle. Scottish Tory leader Ruth Davidson is among those who have rebuked Mr. Johnson for stirring trouble. Former Minister Nicky Morgan, who has been pushing for a softer approach to Brexit, laid into Mr. Johnson for undermining the government. The staunch Brexiteers simply won't countenance the necessary give and take. They therefore seek to undermine such an approach at every turn, as we see from Boris Johnson's new set of red lines, she wrote in The Independent. The UK government should be focusing on getting the UK out of the EU in the least damaging way, not debating arbitrary red lines set down to try to curry favour with those who want a utopian ultra-free trade, low tax, minimal regulation state. Fellow Tory MP Anna Soubry wrote on Twitter, "Ed Nicky Morgan 01 at Ruth Davidson's talking much sense. PPLL are fed up W Tory wars and Brexit mixed messages. At Boris Johnson must grow up or go."